Alrighty, so it is December 8th, and today I want to kind of start out with something that happened during work. While I was at work, I was actually just listening to my Christmas playlist, and one of the songs that came up was a song by TobyMac and Tasha Layton, and I want to actually share part of that song, and I don't do justice with singing, so I think it's going to be better if it's coming from them than with me. So I'm going to play a little bit of the song, and then I'm going to kind of talk about how this song relates to the name that I have for today. And just so you guys know, if you want to look up the song later, it's called Christmas Hits Different. I think it's their newest one from this year. So this is going to be about like a minute into the song. So so in their song, TobyMac and Tasha Layton, they're singing about how sometimes for some, the Christmas time isn't always the most cheerful. We often build very, very good memories with loved ones and friends. And sometimes when we lose them, either they can be our grandparents or closer friends and relatives, that these time of years can often be a remembrance of all the times that we're also missing with them since their passing. And as I was listening to this song, I started to think about those in my life that I've lost and that have passed on from mortality. And I remember one time I got home from school and I had a grandmother, well, one of my grandmothers was not doing that well, and we kind of already knew that her time to leave life was gonna approach soon. And I just remember getting home one day, and my brothers in the living room told me that she passed. I was like, no, you guys are lying. Went downstairs, asked my mom, and she affirmed that it was true. I went into my room and I started to cry, and this was in the springtime, but I remember I was just crying, and the thing that came to my mind was everything that we are taught in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints about the plan of salvation. We're told that we lived in heaven as spirit children, and that we are sent to earth to gain mortality, to gain a physical body, because we didn't have one before, and coming to earth is the only way we can obtain one. And that as we're here, we'll all face challenges, and at some point we're going to die and depart mortality, leaving loved ones behind. And that when we leave, we'll go to the spirit world to await the second coming of Jesus Christ. But when the second coming occurs, we are told that everyone will be able to receive a resurrected immortal body. And I was thinking about this when my grandmother passed away, and that was the biggest blessing. In 1 Corinthians 15, verse 22, it says, "For in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive." And so that's where that teaching comes from, that everyone will be made alive after they have passed. That is a gift given to each individual who comes to earth. And when Lazarus passed and died, Jesus, he tarried, he waited. This was purposeful for him. He waited until the fourth day to raise Lazarus from the dead. In the Jewish cult custom and belief, they believe that the spirit will dwell around their body for 3 days before they leave completely. And so it's a very important thing that Jesus waited till after that time had passed, showing forth his power and saying, "No, I am the resurrection and the life," which that is the name for today, because he has the power to raise people from the dead, either back into mortality or even unto immortality. And knowing that he has that power brings a lot of hope and joy. And even though I have that understanding and that belief that he is the resurrection and the life, and that in him all can be made alive, I'm not gonna deny saying that I don't feel pain. I'm not miserable sometimes after losing someone, or even thinking about those that I've passed even years later. I still grieve every once in a while, but that grief is swallowed up in my joy and in my understanding. So if this year, Christmas does hit different, quoting TobyMac, I would ask you to not feel ashamed about missing those who have passed, even if it's been years. But I hope that you will look to Jesus Christ as a source of peace and as a way to come to understand his power and what his plan is and his timing, to be able to bring your loved ones back so that you can embrace them. Fridays, the reason why I wanted to do it today on a Friday is because I work in one of our temples in Utah as one who helps officiate with ordinances. And in the temple, we often teach about the plan of salvation and how Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. And it's important to remember that in those temples, in those sacred houses of the Lord, we perform ordinances for those who have passed on so that they can have an opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as their Savior and Redeemer, and to enter in at the gate as Jesus Christ taught. And it's important to remember that their families can be sealed together for eternity, that life and family can be perpetuated beyond the grave. This is why we build temples in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. It was something that they did in the Bible, and it's something that we continue to do today. And it's important that we go there often to find peace and also to remind ourselves of that power that Jesus Christ has over life and death. And I know that he will come and that he will bring everyone back into a physical body, and that we will be able to return to Heavenly Father through him. I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.